Welcome students to session number 52 of chapter number 5 laws of motion. Today we are going to study a very important topic, that is law of conservation of linear momentum. Before moving into the topic of law of conservation of linear momentum, I want to tell you that this law of conservation of momentum is derived from two laws that we have already studied, that is Newton's second law of motion, Newton's third law of motion, out of which a very fundamental principle is being derived, that is nothing but law of conservation of linear momentum. Now see, law of conservation of linear momentum states that in absence of external force in a system of several particles, the total linear momentum of the system is conserved. The total linear momentum of the system is conserved in absence of any external force acting on the system. Now, total linear momentum conserved means the total linear momentum of the particle is vector addition of all the momenta of individual particles. If you want to find out the total linear momentum of the system, then we have to do the vector addition of individual momenta of all the particles. If we'll add it, we'll get what? Total linear momentum of the system. So the law of conservation of momentum I have written: in absence of any external force on a system of several particles, the linear momentum of the system remains conserved. And I'll add one more thing, that is the total linear momentum. The total linear momentum of the system is vector sum of momenta of all particles of the system. Is moment sum of vector sum of moment of all particles of the system. Hope it is clear. Now let us derive the equation for it. Consider a system of several particles, n particles we can say. Clear? We are considering a system of n particles. Perfectly clear? Having mass is m1, m2, m3 up to mn. Why I am taking m1, m2, m3 up to mn? Because we have considered n particle system. Clear? So that particles are having mass m1, m2, m3, mn and moving with velocities. I am going to take v1, v2, v3 up to vn. Respectively, having individual momenta, we can say that is P1, P2, P3, up to PN. Hope it is clear. I have considered a system of what? N particles, individual having masses M1, M2, M3 up to MN, moving with velocities V1, V2, V3, V up to VN. And having momentum what? P1, P2, P3, PN. Clear till this? Hope it is perfectly clear. Fine. Well, we have already told that in absence of external force on a system of several particles, the total linear momentum of the system remains conserved. The total linear momentum of the system is vector sum of moment of all the particles of system. Yes or no? So I can write over here, the total linear momentum of the system. The total linear momentum of the system we need to derive, that is nothing but what? Vector sum of individual momenta. So I can write P, that is equal to first particle, that is m1 v1. Yes sir, linear momentum is the product of what? Mass into velocity. So for the first particle it will be mass m1, velocity v1. For second particle m2 v2. Very good. For third particle m3 v3. Excellent. Up to I'm going to get what? mn vn. Till this clear? This m1 v1 is nothing but what? Can I write p1? This is p2, this is p3, up to I can write it was pn. Clear? Moment of n the particle. So I am going to get my equation p, that is equal to p1 plus p2 plus p3 up to pn. Till this clear? You can say that the total linear momentum of the system is nothing but vector sum of, this is vector quantities, so vector sum of individual momenta of the particles consisting in the system. Till this clear? Okay, fine. Moving ahead, we do able to observe one thing. In Newton's second law, we have observed Newton's second law we have observed. Newton's second law. According to Newton's second law, we have studied the rate of change of momentum with respect to time is nothing but what? External force acting on the system? Yes or no? So I can write dp by dt, that is rate of change of momentum with respect to time is nothing but force. This is the equation for what? Newton's second law of motion. For a system, if no external force, we are considering system where there is no external force. No external force means this F is zero. So I can write over here that is what? dP by dt that is equal to zero. Remember, differentiation of any quantity will come to always zero if that individual quantity is constant. Always remember that differentiation of a constant term is always zero. So I can write that differentiation of constant term is zero. Is this clear? Remember, again I am repeating, differentiation of any conserved quantity, or you can say constant, that is always what? Zero. Again I am highlighting over here, if dp by dt is zero, means p is always constant. Till this clear? 100% clear? I am going to give you example over here, that is if d by dx of 2, I am asking you, 2 is a constant quantity, so your answer is how much? Zero. If somebody asks you d by dx of minus 1 is a constant quantity, your differentiation will be zero. So remember one thing, that is differentiation of constant term is zero. Till this clear? From here we can make it out. In absence of any external force, the total linear momentum of the system is conserved. This is nothing but law of conservation of linear momentum. So I can write that in absence of external force, this is the law of conservation momentum. In absence of external force on a system of particles, yes or no? The linear momentum of the system is conserved. Very good. Conserved means remains constant. Hope it is clear. This is nothing but what? Statement of law of conservation of linear momentum. Hope it is perfectly clear. Very good. This is perfectly clear to you all. Okay. Now we are going to study, that is Newton's third law. Clear? We already know what is Newton's third law. For every action, there is always equal and opposite reaction. Hope it is clear perfectly. Fine. So, we need to derive law of conservation from linear momentum. As shown in figure, consider two particles of masses. We are considering two particles of masses m1 and m2 moving with velocity u1 and u2, moving with velocities u1 and u2, provided u1 is greater than u2. Hope it is clear. There are two particles of masses m1 and m2 moving with velocities u1 and u2, provided u1 is greater than u2. Hope it is clear. Moving with velocity u1 and u2, where u1 is greater than u2. 100% clear? Fine. So we are considering two particles of masses m1. Fine. So we are having two particles of masses m1 and m2 moving with velocities u1 and u2, u1 greater than u2. They collide for small interval time delta t. They collide for time interval delta t. They are moving on a straight line. They are moving in a straight line. There are two particles, again I am repeating, of masses m1 and m2, moving velocities u1 and u2, provided u1 is greater than u2. Also, they collide for some time interval delta t. Till this clear? After collision, what happens? After collision, their velocities, they move with velocity v1 and v2. They move with velocities v1 and v2. So I can take the moves with velocity v1 and v2 respectively. Till this clear? So I am considering again a body A of mass m1 moving with velocity u1 in the same direction, that is body B of mass m2 moving with velocity u2. Till this clear? This condition, this state is nothing but of what we can say before collision. They are moving on a straight path, yes or no? So I can consider to be what, before collision. Hope it is clear. Now what will happen? This will collide. Clear? This will collide means A is colliding with B. What happens? There will be a force exerted by B on A, and similarly there will be in reaction, like according to Newton's third law, every action and reaction are equivalent. But I can say that here that is nothing but what, force exerted on A due to B. Force exerted on A due to B. This is first step. And what, Newton, according to Newton's third law of motion, every action and reaction are equal and opposite. So what will happen? Again, A will give the force to B. So this force is nothing but what? Force given on B due to A. Till this clear? We already know that. What we already know that? According to Newton's third law, FAB, that is equal to minus FBA. This minus represents is direction opposite. Direction opposite, provided magnitude of FAB is always equal to magnitude of FBA. That is Newton's third law. Every action and reaction are equal and opposite. Equal means the magnitude is same, but direction is different. Till this clear perfectly? Very good. So we got this direction. This is figure for what? During collision. This is figure for what? During collision. Till this clear? And it is occurring for how much time? Delta t. Hope it is clear perfectly. After collision, what happens? A, B of mass m1, mass m2 starts moving with velocity v1, and this is moving with v2. Again in same direction. So I can say this is nothing but what, for figure for after collision. This is the figure for after collision. Means after they collide, they again start moving with individual velocities v1 and v2, mass m1 and m2. Hope it is clear perfectly. Very good. Hope it is perfectly clear. Fine. So we have concluded over here, that is FAB that is equal to minus FBA. Fine. 100%. Now for case of FAB, what I'll do? FAB that is nothing but what, force exerted on A due to B. So I can write force exerted on A due to B. Here that is equal to, if I multiply this with time, small time interval, force into time interval. Force into time is nothing but, force into time is nothing but impulse. Very good. Force into time is nothing but impulse. Till this clear? Fine. Impulse is nothing but, I can represent as what? Change in momentum. Yes or no? Change in momentum of A, I can represent. Change in momentum of A. Because force is exerted on A, so there will be change in momentum of A due to B. Till this clear? So this is impulse. If I multiply with one time interval delta t, I am going to get what, change in momentum of A. Change in momentum of A that is equal to what? Change is again final momentum minus what we are going to get, initial momentum. Yes or no? Yes. Change in any quantity is nothing but final value minus its initial value. Final momentum is what? M2. That is first particle. A is first particle. So m1, final velocity is v1, initial mass m1, initial is u1. Initial velocity is before initial momentum, final. Final momentum is after collision. Initial momentum is before collision. So this is the first equation. Similarly, FBA FB is nothing but what? Force exerted on B due to A. Very good. Force exerted on B due to A. Yes or no? Yes or no? So if I multiply this with minus sign, this is minus sign. Yes or no? Or again, I will put it afterwards. This FB that is equal to, there is FBA into, if I say delta T. So my answer is change in momentum of B. Very good. Change in momentum of B. You have to see over here. Clear? So my equation would be what? M2V2 minus M2U2. Till this clear? Final momentum minus initial momentum. Perfectly clear. 100% fine. So now we are moving ahead. Let me get a duster. So I am going to get, if I multiply both the sides by delta t, so yeah, I am going to get FAB delta t here minus FBA delta t from Newton's third law of motion. FBA delta t is nothing but what? Change in momentum of A. Change in, this is impulse, the change in momentum of A, that is equal to minus change in momentum of B. Hope it is cleared perfectly. This is force into time, that is impulse. Impulse is nothing but change in momentum of A. This is force into time is again impulse, but impulse is nothing but change in momentum of B. So change in momentum of A, we have already discussed, that is M1V1 minus M1U1. Clear? It is minus, I can say minus is already there according to Newton's third law. So I can write over here, according to Newton's third law. Yes or no? Yes, very good. So I will put over a minus. My changing momentum of B was M2V2 minus M2U2. Till this clear? So I am going to get my equation M1V1 minus M1U1 minus M2V2 plus M2U2. Till this clear? This minus minus will become plus. Now what I am going to see over here, if I am taking M1, M1 on one side. So M1, V1, V1, I am taking V1 terms. This is U2, this is V2. So what I am going to get, M1 V1 plus M2 V2. I am sending this side and this to be this side. It's M1 U1 plus M2 U2. You will able to notice one thing over here. V1, V2 are the final velocities. So this is total final momentum. Yes or no? Total final means total momentum after collision. And this is total momentum before collision. So you can write, conclude one thing over here. What we have concluded? We have concluded one thing over here, that is total momentum after collision. We were having the equation with us, that is M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to, we do have M1 V1 plus M2 V2. This is nothing but what? Collision, total momentum. Total linear momentum before collision. This is before collision. That is equal to total linear momentum. Total linear momentum. You can say after collision. This is your after collision. Till this clear? This is the before collision. This is your after collision. Think over here. If linear momentum before collision and after collision remains the same, means what? Linear momentum does not change. It is conserved. Clear? So in absence of any external force, you'll be able to notice what? Linear momentum of the system is conserved. This is the thing, but what? You will be able to see that we have derived the equation. We have derived the law of conservation of linear momentum from Newton's third law. Hence, you can say, hence, linear momentum of the system means conserved. Linear momentum of the system is conserved. Clear? We'll see more topic in the next session. Thank you so much.